The Truth app, 1017thetruth.com, and streaming on Spotify, TuneIn, Stitcher, Google Podcast, and Apple Podcast.
To some people, the sound of a baby babbling doesn't mean much. But that's not necessarily true. By 6 months, they're combining vowels and consonants. By 9 months, they're trying out different kinds of sounds. And by 12 months, their babbling is beginning to take on some meaning. Especially if there's no babbling at all. Little to no babbling by 12 months or later is just one of the possible signs of autism in children. Early screening and intervention can make a lifetime of difference and unlock a world of possibilities. Take the first step at autismspeaks.org.
We didn't know what to expect. We were just left in a hotel.
My mom was doing drugs in the house.
Tay and Brianna spent years of their childhood in homes that weren't safe. They were placed in foster care and longed for a permanent, loving home.
I didn't know what my future was.
I wouldn't speak to anyone. I was afraid of everything.
With help from the Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption, Brianna and Tay were adopted and now feel excited about their futures.
I'm studying to be a chef, and I really want to travel the world.
I'm going to be a mechanic, and I can focus on my career.
Right now, in the United States, there are more than 100,000 children in foster care, just like Brianna and Tay, who need a family now. Learn how you can help at DaveThomasFoundation.org.
Join the livest radio show in Milwaukee, Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks. Listen every weekday from noon to 1 p.m. on 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. This is your 1017 The Truth News Update.
I'm Carrie Noni with your news update. A 34-year-old Milwaukee man was fatally shot near 32nd and Hampton on Monday morning, July 31st. The shooting happened around 8:45 a.m. Monday. Officials are seeking an unknown shooter. Anyone with any information is urged to contact Milwaukee Police at 414-935-7360. A 7-year-old boy was shot near 5th and Clark just before 4 p.m. on Sunday, July 30th. Police say two children located an unsecured firearm and it went off, unintentionally striking the victim. The victim was taken to a hospital for treatment of a non-fatal injury. An 11-year-old boy and a 33-year-old woman were arrested. Criminal charges will be referred to the Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office. Police are reminding citizens to secure firearms in a safe place and out of reach of children. Calm Wellness Center had a grand opening Sunday at their new building at 6333 North Green Bay Avenue. The co-owners, Patrice Green and Katrina Francis, said they want Calm to be a place for everyone, from the inner city to the suburbs. The business specializes in integrated healing and self-care. With a team made up of unique local voices, they offer a variety of services like massages, art and craft focused classes, and much more. The center also offers sound healing, resting tents, and wellness classes. They will be open Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. For more information, you can visit their website. Vice President Kamala Harris will travel to Wisconsin on Thursday, August 3rd. The Vice President will travel to Pleasant Prairie to deliver remarks highlighting the Biden-Harris administration's investment in broadband and affordable connectivity. Then, Vice President Harris will travel to Milwaukee to deliver remarks at two campaign receptions. This has been your 1017 The Truth News Update. The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is up next on the new 1017 The Truth.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what, because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of adjustment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up. If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth App.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council, show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. He's back. Like a alien just showed up, rolled in. So, what's been happening since I've been gone? Took some much needed time off, chilled out, went to Dallas, Texas, because I was at the general convention for the Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. And had a great time, hung out, saw some friends I ain't seen in a minute, made some new friends, had some old friends. It was very rewarding, very positive, some great things coming out. I'll be talking about some things that didn't necessarily happen there, but affected the country while I was there. So I have to remind people, I don't speak for the fraternity. So, you know, that's the general president's purview. So I just talk about stuff that impacts me. And sometimes it's the fraternity. And so, you know, I can speak my mind. And if people don't like it, they'll do what they do, as usual. I mean, I heard a story when I was away. You ever do something where you ever rush? And so I always do it. I always sit water down, and also get teased because I tend to put an R on water, and most people from the Middle West do that. You know, they say water, like W-A-R or W-O-R-T-E-R. I rarely call it water. I have to consciously say water. Yes, I'm weird. And so if you're watching on YouTube, and by the way, you can follow me on at Dr. Ken's Truth on, let me see, Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter. But you can watch us. Just search 101.7 The Truth. Or Truth in the Afternoon on YouTube, and you'll find us live. And we're sitting here, you know, twiddling our thumbs. And so while I travel, I listen to a lot of audiobooks, Spotify. And I just happened to be on Spotify listening to a motivational speech. And I forgot who said it or told the story, but somebody was narrating and they told a story. It was about a power plant, and it made me think about how I think about myself and how other people think of themselves. And so we like to call people arrogant or uppity or whatever you want to call them. Oh, they're full of themselves or they're narcissistic and all that. But I think there was a statement made at the end of the speech, and again, forgive me. I know it was on Spotify. It was part of their motivational speeches, and I forget who told it. It might have been Les Brown telling the story or somebody. I don't recall. But there was a power plant that had an issue with power surges, right? So it would work, and they had this new gauge installed. And the new gauge, if you've ever been in a power plant, you ever been outside an apartment building and you saw all the meters outside of an apartment? Like, how could you even figure out which one was for what, right? Because it's for every apartment, there's a meter. So imagine being in a power company that had gauges and meters and all that stuff, right? So they installed the new gauge. They knew it got installed because it got replaced, but it was draining the system. So when I say draining the system, it gave different problems. Like once it would give a brownout, so it would kind of dip but not go out. And then they just straight up blacked out. And then when it wasn't browning out or blacking out, it would surge. So you either didn't get enough power or you got too much. And so the engineers pored over the system for weeks, and the same thing kept happening. Brownouts, blackouts, power surges. So one of the things they did is they called in an outside engineer. Because sometimes when you have issues and you have problems, you're too close to it. They'd had a new gauge put in, couldn't figure out where it was, what it was, how it was. And so the expert surveyed the entire system, right? And after about 3 or 4 hours, left, came back with a bucket of black paint, asked for a ladder. They found a ladder. The engineer climbed up the ladder and put an X on the gauge. Climbed back down the ladder, went over to the control panel, shut off the gauge. That was it. Took the black bucket of paint, closed it up, sat it in the corner. They thanked the engineer, appreciate it, figured out our job. Everything's great. Week later, they got the bill. What do you think the bill was? Guy was there for a couple hours, got his work, went and got some paint, found a ladder, put an X on the gauge, found the gauge, boom, done. Company got a bill from the engineer for $5,000. Well, you can imagine, even though it's a power company, right, worth billions, the fact that you would come in and work a couple hours, two or three to be exact, and get paid $5,000, company was stunned. Like, what? So they called him and they said, hey, how can you justify charging us $5,000 for a few hours work, but all you did is mark it with an X? I mean, think about that. You call somebody, they traveled all the way there, probably was local, went in, worked for a couple hours, went and got a ladder, got some black paint, marked an X, crawled back down, left. Even said thank you. $5,000. The engineer replied, oh, you don't have to worry about that. The X only costs you a dollar. The $4,999 is for knowing where to put the X. What's the translation you need to understand? Translation is, know your worth.
And that is Dr. Ken's Truth on the new 101.7 The Truth.
This is 1017 The Truth's Melanie Ricks, and I am Milwaukee. I love Milwaukee so much. I love how rich the city is in history, and I love how rich we are in the moment. I think that every day there's something new that our city accomplishes, but it's important that we keep remembering that it takes a village to be great, and I know that we can be great as long as we all stick together. So why not stick together and join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth? We are the new 1017 The Truth. Milwaukee, Black, talk.
Achieve your financial dreams faster at Educators Credit Union. Whether you're dreaming of opening your own small business, financing the cost of college, buying a car, or paying for your wedding, Educators Credit Union is by your side with better rates, lower fees, and award-winning member services designed to help you turn your financial dreams into reality. Learn more at ecu.com. Membership is open to anyone who lives or works in southeastern Wisconsin and federally insured by NCUA.
Sharon needed legal help. She needed Gruber Law Offices.
When I think about Gruber Law Office, I think about how they took care of me, how they make sure that you get what you're supposed to get. Gruber Law Office. One call, that's all. I will always, always trust One Call, that's all.
Injured? Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
They are the best. I'm very happy.
I'm Tony Burrell, Superintendent of the Wisconsin State Patrol. Public safety is our primary mission. Every day, our troopers and inspectors work hard to keep people and commerce moving safely. But drivers need to do their part. That means following these simple rules. Buckle up, phones down, slow down. Thanks for helping us move towards zero deaths on Wisconsin roads.
A life-saving message, sponsored by the U.S. and Wisconsin DOTs.
Sometimes I just cannot believe all the storms we've gone through here.
I can only hope that we'll be able to leave this house to you one day, baby. You're our legacy.
Planning for these disasters will make sure we're safe, and is the best way to protect that legacy. You know what? We should make an emergency communication plan. That way we're ready this year. At my dorm, we have emergency kits for earthquakes and wildfires, but I'm sure there's something more local I can send you with the link.
Okay. Smart.
Protect your legacy. Visit ready.gov/plan for the tools and tips you need to start your emergency preparedness plan today. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. The Black-owned business give back. Yep, it's back. We have teamed up with the Associated Bank to help local black businesses grow and succeed together. The home of Milwaukee Black Talk will be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to 5 black businesses each quarter in 2023. To sign up for this incredible marketing opportunity, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. All one word. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure right here on the new 1017 The Truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, one of our founding partners. Member FDIC. So make sure you go check that out. And if you have a business that needs to, you know, get a little bump in business, come holler. All right? Okay. That's what I get for eating the chips that come with Qdoba, right? That's what I get. Eating them before the show. And then you got to clear your throat every 5 seconds. Why is that? Interesting. Interesting. So here's the deal. So I got a question. I got a question. So based on what happened in Florida, we all heard about Florida, Governor Ron DeSantis and some of the things he said and comments he said. I would ask you to look it up so that you're on point with me as it relates to the comments he made about slavery and black people and all that stuff. So, I mean, even Republicans went, wait, what? Did he just say that? Yeah, he just said that. So, he changed standards on how black history is taught in Florida schools. And the social studies standards, which DeSantis has repeatedly defended, include teaching middle class schoolers that slavery develops skills, which in some instances could be applied for their personal benefit. So if you think about all the things that happened in slavery and you put a percentage on it, that would be like what's after billion? Trillion? Zillion? Yeah. One zillionth of what happened to black people when they were slaves. That if they learned how to, say, garden, or learned how to make repairs to a house, or learned how to, pick cotton or farm. Okay. Will Hurd, former Republican congressman from Texas, who's also running for Republican presidential nomination on Sunday, said, slavery is not a jobs program. Anybody that's implying that there was an upside to slavery is insane. I agree. Hurd said he was surprised that DeSantis continues to voice support for the standards, but called his behavior one more part of a fact pattern of Ron DeSantis being mean and hateful. He went on to say that it'd be hard to make the case if Ron DeSantis was Republican nominee that folks in black and brown communities would support him. So, if you have an event in Florida, would you cancel it? That's what I'm asking. If you had an event planned in the future, in the next year or two, in Florida, would you cancel it? Ron DeSantis signed into law the fiscal year budget 2023-2024 for the state of Florida totaling $116.5 billion. Organizations have left. Being transparent, not speaking for the fraternity, Alpha Phi Alpha, you may have seen it on the news and you saw it on social media. Our convention, 2024, was planned to be in Orlando, Florida, and it got canceled. It would have brought $4.6 million to the economy, and they canceled the convention. My personal feelings have nothing to do, because I don't speak for the fraternity. I'm not placing the fraternity in this sphere. I'm speaking in general about organizations that, when something like this happens, feel the need to cancel. Other organizations didn't go to Arizona because they were upset that Arizona was the last state to accept MLK as a federal, as a state holiday, and then the federal holiday came in and superseded it. However, I'm of the impression when things like this happen, and let me know if you agree,
I would not have left. I would have gone to that particular state. And I'm not talking about the fraternity. I'm talking about any organization that is talking about having something in Florida and now they're considering leaving. Oh my God, you're giving all that racist state your tax money. Okay, giving the state your tax money and supporting the governor, I think, are two different things. That's one. Number two, he's just one guy. Number three, they got $116.5 billion in taxes. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to light a fire under their budget or cause those people. What I will do is cause the people who work in the hospitality industry, many of them black and brown and white and Asian, not making money. Is it enough to take a stand to say what you mean without really making an impact? Because $4.6 million or $10 million or $20 million in the guise of $116.5 billion that they got in a budget, I don't think it's going to hold a candle. So then what do you do? Well, that being said, you have to remember, Martin Luther King, when there was an issue in the South, he didn't run away. He ran to it. When there were issues in Selma, issues in Montgomery, he flew to Alabama and marched from Selma to Montgomery while they threw rocks and bricks and bottles and hoses and gunshots, firecrackers. They ran to the fight. I have some suggestions about it, but I want to know. 833-212-1017 is the number. If you were having an event in Florida, first of all, should people even leave Florida? I mean, what happened to us? When there's a fight, do we run from the fight? I don't like you, so I'm gonna take my ball and go home. What impact did you make on Florida? I have some ideas, but I want to know what you think. 833-212-1017. What happened to running to the fight? What happened to going down and supporting the NAACP, the Urban League, the D9, all those organizations that are there fighting and living in Florida like we did Alabama, like we did Montgomery boycott? Well, you know, sometimes somebody, I was having a conversation with somebody, and I can't tell you their name because they're fairly well known and very high up in their organization, but they said, well, you know, sometimes those are the old ways, right? It's amazing when you get younger people when they, those are the old ways. See, protesting is an old way. Sometimes you got to just speak. I said, they got $116.5 billion budget. Are you going to really make an impact on their budget? No. Okay, then stay out the money piece. What can you impact in Florida that would cause them to wake up? What could you impact? Make people take a stand and go, oh, they're serious. Not being there? What does that really do? I mean, I honestly want to know because I'm having trouble seeing it. All these organizations are trashing Florida, but yet that's where the fight is. And when it comes time to take the fight to them, people are deciding, no, we're just not going to go. Which leads me to ask questions like, well, where are you going to go? Name me a state, Democrat or Republican run, that's actually safe for black people. That's actually done and supported things for black people. Because none that I know are actually run by black people. They're run by majority whites. Like, I can't think of a state, so... Eight three three two one two one zero one seven is the number. If you were having an event in Florida, my question to you is, would you cancel it?
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Life's better with an auto policy from American Family Insurance. No matter what dreams you're driving towards. That's because our expert agents will make you feel totally protected with the right auto coverage at the right price. You'll also save up to 23% when you bundle auto with home. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The golden days of summer are here. More Brewers games, sun-drenched days of tailgating, and exhilarating summer nights are waiting for you at American Family Field. Embrace it all with your crew while Brewers baseball season reaches its peak, because the best days of the year won't be here forever. Make the most of it and plan your game day at Brewers.com today.
Victor deployed for the first time to Afghanistan in 2003. At 4 in the morning, my phone rang. They said, "I regret to inform you that your husband was wounded in action." Victor sustained a moderate traumatic brain injury. I was doing school full time, and I was also then caring for Victor. One of the most important elements of caregiving is taking care of yourself. I just didn't want to forget that I also had goals and that I also had a life. What I did is I challenged Victor to meet me halfway. There are almost 6 million military and veteran caregivers across the nation. We have our own journey, and we can fulfill that journey at the same time that we are helping our loved one.
Visit aarp.org/caregiving for a free military veteran's guide to navigate your caregiving journey and better care for your loved one and yourself. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Kids across America are going to school hungry. Millions of kids every day. Hungry kids get sick more often and can struggle in school. It can be harder for them to focus and learn. But one simple thing can help change all of this for a hungry child in America. Good healthy food and the energy it brings. With help from caring people across America, No Kid Hungry is providing healthy meals and hope to hungry kids so they can build better futures.
We want to ensure that all of our kids have healthy meals every day.
Thank you.
Thank you for helping feed our kids.
To learn more about ending child hunger in America, go to helpnokidhungry.org today.
Delays continue along southbound 43, heading down from about Silver Spring, just before Silver Spring, all the way down to about Keefe. And then we got the northbound side slowing down from North Avenue up past Keefe as well. Southbound on 41, slowing from before Silver Spring all the way down to Mayfair Road. And on the Rock Freeway, heading southbound, slowing down from Beloit Road all the way down past Moreland Road. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, mainly clear and comfortable, a low of 63 at the lakefront, 58 inland. Tomorrow, hazy sunshine with a high of 83. For the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga on 1017 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 1017 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Brandon Snide. It was a weekend Brewers fans will soon want to forget, as the Atlanta Braves busted out the brooms to complete the series sweep of Milwaukee with the 8-6 win over the Brewers on Sunday afternoon. With the loss, the Brewers now trailing the Cincinnati Reds in the NL Central Division by half a game. The Brewers will look to rebound in Washington tonight with Corbin Burns slated to get the start. That first pitch is set for 6:05. Over to the NFL, as the Green Bay Packers wrapped up week one of training camp on Sunday. Beginning today, the pads coming on in
title town as head coach Matt LaFleur ensures the standard remains high for his football team in Green Bay.
The expectations are this, that guys go out there and compete to the best of their ability each and every day. If they come here with a great attitude and great energy.
Day 5 of training camp will get underway later today. This sports update is brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown teams. Member FDIC.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Hey, Truth Nation, we want you to join us for our free and open to the public Truth Family Fest on Saturday, August 12th from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Riverside University High School right here in the city of Milwaukee. We are bringing the community together for a free family festival that will have something for everyone. There'll be live music, free haircuts for kids. Dang, I can't get a haircut. Oh, well. Delicious food, healthcare resources, financial education resources, and free giveaways. Can't wait to see you Saturday, August 12th, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. right here for our Truth Family Fest, Riverside University High School in Milwaukee. The Truth Family Fest is sponsored by Ascension Wisconsin Educators Credit Union, Hunger Task Force, and Associated Bank, member FDIC. So make sure you come hang out. I think we'll have producers and hosts and teammates and marketing and food and food and food. You know what I'm saying? Y'all see why I'm showing up? Oh, I want to see the Truth Nation. Nope, I'm showing up to eat. I'm going to eat. I'm not going to even lie about it. I'm going to eat. Stuff my face. I'm doing the UNCF walk run that morning. And then I'm showing up at the Truth Family Festival, eat myself into a tizzy. And then when I'm done with that, guess what? It's a date party going on, so I'm going to be hanging out and talking about that too. So I'm just going, I'm going to probably get up at about, I don't know, 5 in the morning. And I'll probably get home about 5 in the morning. So that'll be interesting. 833-212-1017 is the number. Before the break, we were talking about this whole Florida issue and whether or not we're going to, are we just going to pull out of Florida, move, leave, whatever? Like all the people I know that retired that just moved to Florida, right? People built houses in Florida. I'm not a lover of Florida only because Florida was one of those places where the humidity just killed me. It wasn't like that dry heat in Dallas or Phoenix or, you know what I mean, New Mexico. It's that wet, humid, you walk outside and walk 5 feet and then just dripping wet. Can't do it. Not to mention hurricanes. So, I mean, I've literally lived through a tornado or two. I've watched them dip over houses and cars and businesses and skip overhead while I was sitting there. I think a hurricane is a whole other level of something that I couldn't do. So Florida's just not a place for me anyway. But at some point, I think we need to be in Florida. So here's what I would do. And you tell me, 833-212-1017. You tell me, because boycotting actually hurts people that work there too, right? So here's what I was thinking to do. However, talking text line, Grant said, in most cases, boycotts and cancellations like your fraternity did are not singular. Other organizations are made aware of wrongdoings and decide, yeah, we're canceling too. Momentum builds, and before you know it, there are 10 or 15 cancellations. Yes, even if it were fewer, this is impactful. Explain to me how, Grant. Like me keeping my money in my pocket when there's $116.5 billion worth of tax money already in their budget, am I really going to make an impact? Because I have some ideas. And that's a good argument. And to a point, I agree with you. What's next, though? Boycott their pocketbook. Walmart, Walgreens, just like UPS did. I don't know what that means, and I don't know what you're talking about, so you might have to explain that one, Derek. But, however, what's a boycott going to do? I wonder. See, for me, a boycott would be business A. Okay, this is what I would do, and I'm not saying do this. I can't say it. I can't say it. Because if I say it, somebody will do it, then they'll trace it back to me, and then I'll be. Derek said there are casualties of war. I get that. But the casualties will be the people there that look like us that work there. So you're not hurting them. I mean, ask those companies in San Francisco where there's so much crime. They closed down the anchor store for Whole Foods. Like, they shut it. Amazon shut it down. Hey, we're done. Like, it's gotten to the point where you're taking so much money, we'll just shut it down. Like, what happens to the people in that neighborhood then when they shut down Walgreens and Walmart and all that? I'm just using those companies as examples. They haven't done anything. Then what? We're just, oh, we shut them down. Right. And then, like, 1,000 people lose their job. Then what? Are you going to pay the tax money? Oh, that's right. You don't live in Florida, so you don't pay the tax money that would then help them with unemployment, which the company pays. It just makes no sense to me. And so I need to figure out what to do other than just say, we're going to boycott, and that's it. Grant said, DeSantis is running for president of the United States. Negative press. Dude. Have you seen DeSantis? He's dropping in the polls like a rock. They're talking about if he wants to continue to run, he will have to restart his campaign. He will have to reengage because Trump is going up, DeSantis is going down, and everybody else in the race is going up. What does that tell you about DeSantis? Republicans even turned on him. Like, dude, what's wrong with you? Like, what are you, stupid? So 15 cancellations is not going to put a dent in Florida. Showing up in Florida. Now, here's what I would have done. And I'm not speaking of my fraternity. I'm speaking of the Truth Fraternity. There you go. The fictitious Truth Fraternity, right? We're going to not only go to Florida, we're not going to Orlando. We're not going to Miami. We're going to Tallahassee. I think Tallahassee is the capital of Florida, where I'm pretty sure there's a governor's mansion. So if I can get about 5,000 people, and if I was really being vindictive, I would tell every organization I knew of that we're going to pick a week and we're going to hold our conventions one after the other. After the other, after the other. And since each of us is going to bring anywhere between 3,000 and 5,000 people, I would rotate and change my organizational order of business just so every single day there's at least 1,000 people at the governor's house, at the mansion with a permit, doing it legally, protesting. Every day. Think of the how many weeks? 9 fraternities and sororities, Prince Hall Masons, Urban League, 100 Black Men. I mean, think about it. NAACP. And those are just the ones off the top of my head. National Black NBA Association, HBCU colleges, there would be a group of about 1,000 people every day for the foreseeable future outside the mansion. And now, I'm not saying do that. I'm by no means saying do that. I'm saying those are the types of impactful things you can do. those are the type, without destroying the economy for the people who are at the bottom of the economy who need jobs and hospitality. That's all I'm saying. We got to figure out a way how to undergird them as well. But running from a fight, that makes no sense to me. Makes no sense. 833-212-1017 is the number. I get it, Grant. I get what you're saying. I get it, Derek. But at some point, you know, you can't be a casualty of war from 1,000 miles away. You can't turn on the TV and go, oh, that's too bad for those people down there, but I'm not going. Like, think if Martin Luther King decided to look at TV, look at what the woman before Rosa Parks, who actually did a boycott, and then Rosa Parks, and decided, oh, that's cute, what's she doing down there? Let's boycott. Let's not go to Montgomery. Let's stay here in Georgia. What do you think would have happened? Nothing. It's when they showed up that it impacted. Derek said, Dr. Ken, you're always against I'm not against boycott and marching. I'll boycott and march. Like that. Did you not hear what I just said? You just talk and try to get people to think about what might happen to them. Dr. King was not just talk. He got off his duff and showed people how to do it. And how many marches have you been in, Derek? I've been in quite a few. Are you old enough to remember the 60s and the 70s and the 80s and the marching and being in Chicago and marching for voting rights and all? All right. Because you seem to assume that you know me when, in fact, you really don't. And I don't know you either. But I can only speak for me. Done that before. But see, boycotting has only changed one or two things. I'm talking about making lasting impact. And to make a lasting impact, you got to be there. You got to show up and be present. We're losing a generation because they have learned not to show up and be present. They want to phone it in, send a text, you know, complain. When in fact, sometimes you just got to be there. And showing up in Florida every day for 6 months to a year on end, I think that speaks. Derek said, Dr. Ken, I'm 70 and from Chicago. I can't confirm that. Can you confirm that, Derek? No, I'm just kidding. But think about it. Did you march, Derek? Did you walk in 68 when King was killed and they started, you know, with the National Guard rolling down the street, feeling the street vibrate because the tanks were rolling down 75th Street and all throughout the city, and daily put out the shoot to kill that if you're out after 5 o'clock, if you loot, the police were to shoot and kill you, and they would not be tried. I mean, think about the stuff like that. And if Derek grew up in Chicago during those times, he should remember that. That's when people stood up. Like, if you're standing up to actually create change. Because if you are, then you have to remember it really does come down to ride or die.
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
The 1017 The Truth Street Team, sponsored by UW Credit Union, is coming to an event near you. Join us this Wednesday at Washington Park from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. to celebrate Washington Park Wednesday's Summer Concert Series. It will be a night of music, food, and fun. Also, come enjoy the Black Arts Fest MKE this Saturday from noon until 10 p.m. at the Summerfest grounds. The festival strives to educate all and strengthen pride in African ancestry. The 1017 The Truth Street Team is sponsored by UW Credit Union. They are here for every you.
When looking for a healthcare provider, you want someone who genuinely cares about you, which is why Health Connections Incorporated is where it's at. They're a Black, woman-led nonprofit organization that provides both clinical and non-clinical healthcare. The direct clinical care they provide includes primary care, HIV care and prevention, and transgender health. HCI leaders are advocates, activists, decision makers, speakers, organizers, and collaborators on social determinants of health that impact healthcare access and health equity for all. Sign up for their mailing list at healthconnectmke.org.
Adrian was seriously injured when a careless driver merged into her lane.
Gruber was there for everything that I needed. Any questions that I had, Gruber was there. They made me feel like everything about my situation and my accident was very important to them. And that made me feel good. And I would definitely call Gruber again for that.
Serving Wisconsin for over 35 years, Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
They go above and beyond for their clients.
Are you a veteran who needs assistance? Do you know a veteran who needs help? The Wisconsin Department of Veterans Affairs is here for Wisconsin veterans, their families, and their survivors. We can help connect veterans with services such as medical care, financial and legal assistance, housing, mental health services, substance use treatment, and more. For more information, please visit wisvets.com. That's wisvets.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Department of Veterans Affairs, with funding provided by the Milwaukee Brewers and the Brewers Community Foundation.
Hey, wouldn't it be great if life came with a remote control? You know, you could hit pause when you needed to, or hit rewind, like that time you knocked down that wasp's nest.
Uh-oh.
Or that time you forgot to roll up your windows in the car wash.
Fantastic.
Yeah, a remote control would have come in handy then. Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome. But prediabetes does. With early diagnosis and a few healthy changes like managing your weight, getting active, stopping smoking, and eating healthier, you can stop prediabetes before it leads to type 2 diabetes. It's easy to learn your risk. Take the 1-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org. Life doesn't come with a remote control.
Yikes!
So you're on your own with the wasps. You have the power to take control of prediabetes. Visit doihaveprediabetes.org today. That's doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its prediabetes awareness partners.
The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. We want to celebrate survivors of breast cancer and highlight their stories of fighting and thriving through their diagnosis. And so, Truth Nation, we want you to visit 1017 The Truth's YouTube page and watch Carrie Noni's interview with our beloved general manager, Cherie Harris, as she discusses how she thrived through her diagnosis. To celebrate her journey, for a limited time only, we are selling specialty 1017 The Truth shirts. Go to, do I get a shirt? I don't get a shirt. Wow, I got to pay money. All right, I'll pay some money. Go to 1017thetruth.com right now. Purchase your limited edition Thrive Through shirt. All proceeds go to support the Frederick and the Medical College of Wisconsin Breast Cancer Care and Research Fund. So, to support this effort, we ask you to visit 1017thetruth.com, purchase a limited edition Truth shirt, and support the fight against breast cancer. All proceeds go to support the Frederick and the Medical College of Wisconsin Breast Cancer Care and Research Fund. Okay. And so while she's playing music, I'm going to go to 1017thetruth. Buy a shirt. Buy a shirt live. Because I think we talk about doing, but you know, every now and then it just comes down to literally putting your money where your mouth is. And if you're gonna support it. So that's what you do. So I'm gonna jump on. How much them shirts? Like $50? 50 cent? 50 million? Does it matter? It's about helping understand, especially in the Black community, making sure that research is done with people that look like us, because we know bodies are different based on where they're from. DNA differs based on differences in your body, melanin, ethnicity, where you're from, what region. And so we have to be cognizant of that. You know, it's not by accident the air is heavier in Africa, so our noses are larger and have larger openings than people who are from Northern Europe, where the air is colder and they have thinner noses, because you have to inhale. You know, I'm going to inhale a lot of cold air. But then if it's heavy, you need the ability to be able to inhale more air. You know, little things that I'd never thought about growing up. And then I did this really ridiculous thing called go to school and went, oh, wow, there are differences in people. Yeah. We all bleed red, though. We all get diseases that can impact our lives and impact our families. And so it's time to, you know, step up and be present. And so probably the easiest way to step up is to buy a t-shirt, knowing that you're helping support breast cancer research. And don't get it twisted. Men can get breast cancer too. And so we have to make sure that we are, as I like to say, present for the fight. Fighting from a distance don't really help. Kickboxing from across the street. Sounds good, but it really don't work. It really doesn't work. I don't think. 833-212-1017 is the number. Mr. Medee said, happy Monday, Dr. Can, and that he grew up on the south side of Milwaukee, the best side. Derek said he's from the west side. Where you from, Derek, in the west side? I grew up in Chatham and Park Manor. Where'd you grow up on the west side? So, for those of you that don't know, in Chicago, where you grew up is based on what neighborhood you lived in. So places like, or the place, you know, I ran into a guy the other day. He said, oh, yeah, I grew up on the south side of Chicago. And I said, where? He said, Roseland. That gives you a very, very specific place, neighborhood, 111th of Michigan, exactly where he grew up at. Whereas I grew up in, like, I could be in Milwaukee and people say, yeah, Sherman Park. You're like, I don't know what that is. You know? But, or you could say, you know, Sherman and Locust or Sherman and Center or Sherman and whatever. And people go, oh, okay. I had to get used to that. Oh, yeah, I grew up on 49th and so-and-so. I grew up on 83rd and, oh, okay. Because from Chicago. Now, it was weird when you asked somebody from Chicago where they were from and they told you across street, you knew they weren't from Chicago. Because we use neighborhoods. Or we use a landmark, like Lim's Barbecue on East 75th Street. Like, everybody on the south side knew where Lim's Barbecue was. And there was another barbecue place on 83rd and Cottage Grove that we used to go to. But those are the landmarks. Oh, Madison and Costner. Yeah, dude, you was on the west side, player. Oh, yeah. K-Town, yep. And so that's what we called neighborhoods nicknames as well. He grew up in K-Town. And there's a series of streets that all start with the letter K. And so it's called K-Town on the west side. But if you grew up on Madison, Pulaski and Congress, okay. Yeah. And so it's weird that different cities have different ways of saying where they live and how you live. Because, you know, I think of Sherman Park, but Sherman Park is pretty darn big. Like, I didn't know it was that big. So then I look at the street and go, huh? Yeah. Lim's Barbecue. Yep. Lim's Barbecue on 75th Street. Yep. The Lemon family. I knew the whole Lemon family. The father and then the daughter and the brother and all that. So, yeah. All right. Sounds pretty cool. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. At 5 o'clock, we'll have the top five at 5, some information. I'll try to be in the middle because there's a lot of shootings. My top five stories would be shooting, or juvenile shot. No, we're not going to do that. We'll figure it out. 833-212-1017 is the number.
Truth Nation, this is Sherwin Hughes, and we want you to join us for our inaugural Truth Family Fest on Saturday, August 12th from 10 a.m. until 3 p.m. at Riverside University High School in Milwaukee. We're bringing the community together for a family festival that will have something for everyone. There will be live music, delicious food, financial resources, healthcare resources, and free haircuts for the kids. So mark your calendars for Saturday, August 12th to come out to our Truth Family Fest sponsored by Ascension Wisconsin, Educators Credit Union, Hunger Task Force, and Associated Bank.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee, Black. Talk.
Truth Nation, it is Denise Thomas.
And Telly Hughes.
From Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. And guess what?
What is that, DT?
Our Truth fans can now watch and stream us live every day, Telly.
Wait a minute, Denise. Let me make sure I got this thing right. Our amazing and incredible Truth fans can go to 1017thetruth.com, click the Watch Live link, and watch me and you do our thing live from YouTube and Twitter every morning?
Yes, Telly, that is exactly right. So now they can watch you almost lose your black card every Friday during our Truth Telling Hit segment.
Come on now. You know I'm never losing my black card. But Truth Nation, you gotta tune into all your favorite 101.7 The Truth shows, as you can not only listen live on the app, but you can also stream us live all day, every day, by going to 1017thetruth.com and clicking the Watch Live link.
Do you worry about how much someone drinks?
Do you feel angry or depressed most of the time? Do you feel neglected or unloved?
Do you feel you attract people who tend to be compulsive or abusive?
Do you have money problems because of someone else's drinking?
Are you afraid or embarrassed to bring your friends home?
Do you feel that if the drinker loved you, she or he would stop drinking?
If you answered yes to any of these questions, you are not alone.
More than half of all adults have a family history of alcoholism.
Not everyone trapped by alcohol is an alcoholic.
Families and friends are suffering too.
Al-Anon and Alateen can help.
Call 1-866-200-0223 or visit alanon.org/help.
Get the truth and nothing but the truth with Sherwin Hughes every weekday from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. on 101.7 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
This is your 101.7 The Truth News Update.
I'm Carrie Noni with your news update. A 34-year-old Milwaukee man was fatally shot near 32nd and Hampton on Monday morning, July 31st. The shooting happened around 8:45 a.m. Monday. Officials are seeking an unknown shooter. Anyone with any information is urged to contact Milwaukee Police at 414-935-7360. A 7-year-old boy was shot near 5th and Clark just before 4 p.m. on Sunday, July 30th. Police say two children located an unsecured firearm and it went off, unintentionally striking the victim. The victim was taken to a hospital for treatment of a non-fatal injury. An 11-year-old boy and a 33-year-old woman were arrested. Criminal charges will be referred to the Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office. Police are reminding citizens to secure firearms in a safe place and out of reach of children. Calm Wellness Center had a grand opening Sunday at their new building at 6333 North Green Bay Avenue. The co-owners, Patrice Green and Katrina Francis, said they want Calm to be a place for everyone, from the inner city to the suburbs. The business specializes in integrated healing and self-care. With a team made up of unique local voices, they offer a variety of services like massages, art and craft focused classes, and much more. The center also offers sound healing, resting tents, and wellness classes. They will be open Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. For more information, you can visit their website. Vice President Kamala Harris will travel to Wisconsin on Thursday, August 3rd. The Vice President will travel to Pleasant Prairie to deliver remarks highlighting the Biden-Harris administration's investment in broadband and affordable connectivity. Then, Vice President Harris will travel to Milwaukee to deliver remarks at two campaign receptions. This has been your 101.7 The Truth News Update. The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris continues on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of a judgment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up. If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth and the Truth app.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council, show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. We're going to jump into the top five of five, and here's number five. So believe it or not, this was just bizarre. I heard about this when I was out of town, and I just, like, a Milwaukee woman is dead after a Greenfield police officer accidentally ran over her while responding to the welfare check about her. Milwaukee medical examiners identify the woman, 42-year-old Tracy Dorpat. Incident happened just before 6:30 p.m. last Thursday, 34th and Holmes in Greenfield. According to a release, the responding officer was unaware that a woman was lying in the roadway when the officer hit her. I see a squirrel in the car. I see cats all the time when I'm driving. I slam on my brakes, says Lexi Bissell, Dorpat's daughter. So I'm not sure how you don't see three-fourths of a person. Police said the officer stopped, called for an ambulance, and rendered aid. And the medics took the 42-year-old woman to a hospital where investigators say they believed it was non-life-threatening, but she died later in the hospital. The daughter, Bissell, said that, "I feel like if you run over someone in the stomach, that's immediately life-threatening. She was taken... She was talking and was awake and alert, and so that's probably what they thought. Maybe she feels fine." Her family did not learn their mother was going to die until 11 o'clock p.m. when the hospital called them. She went on to say, "It's absolutely crazy, and everyone wants answers. We're waiting to hear from the police department on how this could have happened, how they did not see her in the road." You can visibly or clearly see her in pain in the abdomen area and back area. By the time the ambulance came, she got onto the bed on her own power, says Kyle Best, the neighbor on the scene. It just didn't feel like a life-threatening type of situation. But anytime you would get hit by a car, even bumped, I remember downtown there was a young man who was in his teens who was walking across the street leaving school and got sideswiped by a car and bumped. And they stopped and got the information, and they said he wasn't going to go to the hospital. Later, he didn't feel well, went to the hospital, and passed away. And so, you know, bumps are dangerous no matter what age, no matter what. So if you get run over by a car, but I guess everybody did the best. I guess they did the best that they could do. And here's story number four. Milwaukee police are investigating a fatal shooting that happened near 28th and Villard. This is a couple of hours old. Police say a 53-year-old man sustained fatal gunshot injuries. Circumstances leading up to the shooting are under investigation. Anyone with information is asked to contact Milwaukee police at 414-935-7360. If you want to remain anonymous, Crime Stoppers, 414-224-TIPS, or the P3 Tips app. Never knew they had something like that. Number three. This was heartbreaking, and this is something I talked about before I left, and people didn't understand. Why have people texting me? Why are you talking about that? And why? When it's hot outside, you need to check on your neighbors. Be neighborly. An 84-year-old man is dead after it was discovered on Saturday, July 29th. The power was out in his apartment, and his home oxygen unit, which requires electricity, failed. And so you need a backup. You need a backup plan. If you know someone doesn't have the ability to move from place to place because they're on oxygen, check on them. I think whenever something changes, we should always check on people. But, you know, that's just me. Here's number two. An early morning crash that caused the vehicle to slam into a small business at 84th and Capitol on Saturday. AJ Ujit Furs is now boarded up, and the owner says his customers are afraid to travel to his shop and bring in business because of their reckless driving in the area. This is nonstop, do you hear me? Says Genevieve Moore, who lives just a block away from the intersection where the crash happened. Do you hear me? It's always an accident over here. They drive down the street 80 miles an hour. I almost got hit over here crossing the street. I had the right of way, and a guy was taking a right-hand turn and almost ran me over. So it was no surprise to Moore when she saw the boarded-up shop. Surveillance video obtained by TMJ4 News, which is where this comes from, TMJ4.com, shows a car traveling east on Capitol Drive crashed into another car making a left turn. They say no injuries were reported, but it's no surprise. It's really no surprise. You see it overnight when you drive around. You don't even need to be doing anything. Somebody will pass you going 90 miles an hour in the right lane, and then two other cars behind it, and it just keeps happening. The owner of the shop, Rodney Ugent, invited TMJ4's Ryan Jenkins inside for a closer look at the damage. He didn't want to be interviewed, but said this is the third time in as many years that his shop has been crashed into. He said his customers are telling him they're scared to bring in business because of all the reckless driving. And he said, I'm tired of it. I'm sick and tired of these idiots that have no regard for human life. I mean, literally, it's a weapon on four wheels, said Milwaukee Alderman Lamont Westmoreland, who represents the district where the crash happened. Jenkins went to Milwaukee's City Hall to ask Westmoreland about the impact of, this is the reporter from TMJ4.com, about the impact of reckless driving. And Jenkins asks, if these businesses were to have to leave because of reckless driving, what impact would it be on the neighborhood? And Westmoreland replied, bad. I mean, it's a domino effect. One business leaves, another one leaves. That's the last thing we want. He's hoping the new policy changes and the new 2% sales tax set to take effect in January can help combat the destruction. I know money is a thing, but those bump outs, they do work. They do slow down traffic, but those need to go all the way to Highway 100 in Capitol. And I kind of actually agree. Now here's my top story. Here's number one. Believe it or not, this happened. And I had to tell the story because I listened to it and followed it while I was in Texas. So, well, Frisco, Texas police chief issued an apology last week after a family from Little Rock, Arkansas, this is from CNN.com, headed to a basketball tournament in Grapevine, Texas, was mistakenly pulled over in a high-risk stop. Now, if you don't know what a high-risk stop is, that means that when you pull the car over, you believe that this person is wanted for a felony and that it's either a violent felony or something meaningful where you pull them out of the car at gunpoint. You don't approach the car. You don't talk to the people. You don't run driver licenses or anything like that. You pull them out at gunpoint, and you deal with it after the fact. Well, this car was on its way to a basketball tournament, and a Frisco officer ran the plates as being from Arizona instead of from Arkansas, leading the police to believe it was stolen. And according to body camera video and information released by the police, on July 23rd, a Frisco officer saw a black Dodge Charger without a state plates leave a hotel and ran a check of the vehicle's license plate. So number one, I know because you're in the street and I know because you are in public, you have a right to run a plate that's on a public street. I get that. Why you pick the Dodge Charger? I don't know. Were the windows tinted? What was in your mind when you did that, right? Because out of all the places leaving a hotel, you ran this car. According to a news release from Frisco Police, when entering the information, get this, the officer mistakenly entered the plate as being from Arizona, typed in AZ instead of Arkansas. I believe it's AR because Alaska's AK. Causing an incorrect registration return led the police to believe the vehicle was possibly stolen. They initiated a high-risk traffic stop on the Dallas North Tollway, waited for backup officers to arrive, the release said. Police closed down southbound lanes of the tollway, conducted a high-risk stop, which the department says is standard procedure for stolen cars. I get it. Body camera video from two officers released by the department last Friday shows a mother who was driving and her sixth grade son, who was in the back seat, being ordered out of the vehicle. Slowly exit the vehicle, face away from us, turn around, do not face us. One officer who has his gun toward the car, drawn toward the car, everybody in the car, hands outside the window, driver, lift up your shirt, only for us to see your waistband, turn around slowly. Those are normal things you do. Right? You make the person stand their hands up, turn in a circle slowly, keep turning, you know, raise your shirt up, all that stuff. If you reach into the car, you may get shot, so be careful. This is what the officer shouts. Do not reach in the car. The officer shouts once they've been told the driver that her license, she was told by the driver that her licensed handgun is locked in the glove compartment. Police say the incident is under review. So Frisco Police Chief David Shilson said in a statement Friday, "We made a mistake. Our department will not hide from its mistakes. Instead, we will learn from them." The officer involved quickly accepted responsibility for what happened, which speaks to integrity. No, it doesn't. It's on video. Come on. I've spoken with the family. I empathize with them and completely understand why they're upset. Body cam footage shows, get this, body cam footage shows the officer who initiated the stop talking to the mother aside and questioning her about her car tags. The woman tells the officer that the children in the back seat are her son and her nephew. Meanwhile, body camera video shows the driver's husband talking to a second officer and say, "Listen, sir, this is my wife's car. We're just in a basketball tournament. I'm a basketball coach. Look at this, bro." And he continues as his son is heard crying, I got concealed carry. Y'all put a gun in my son's face for no reason. Sergeant arrived, and officers realized they had made a mistake. One officer explained that it was an honest mistake. This is terrible, responds the father. Y'all got to do your job, but we're all legit. The officer tells the family after a sergeant ordered officers to stand down and called off the high-risk stop, said, it looks like I made a mistake, so I ran it AZ for Arizona instead of AR for Arkansas. And that's what happened. The father responded, it could have gone wrong for all of us. So distraught, the driver's husband could be seen turning away and breaking into tears. The officer said, we're so sorry that this happened. We had no intent on doing this, you know. We're humans as well as we make mistakes, and I'm not justifying anything. I'm just saying, like, it wasn't a computer that ran it. It was our human error that did this, so please forgive us. Now, according to the incident review was initiated that day to determine what happened, how it was managed, to evaluate what needed to be addressed to prevent this from happening in the future. Police said an ongoing review would identify further changes to the department's training policies and procedures. And the chief apologized on behalf of the department, assured them that they would hold themselves accountable and provide transparency. What would you do if that happened to you? 833-212-1017 is the number. What would you do? I mean, you get pulled over, police point a gun at you. The officer made a mistake, albeit a big one, a mistake. What are your thoughts? Al, you're on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Well, it's a sad case, but speaking from my heart, I wouldn't accept their apology. I would not forgive them because when they took that action, they already knew what they was going to do. And I hope I would be able to sue them for everything they got from their first to their last generation.
What do you mean? Now, what do you mean they knew what they were going to do?
When you pull a gun, and keep in mind, they always have stuff. It's a mistake when a black man get his head blown off. It's, oh, we made a mistake. Oh, we're so sorry. Keep your apology.
But they didn't.
And that's just how I feel.
Okay. But they didn't.
That's just how I feel.
I get it. But they didn't. They actually said, we made a mistake. So do you not?
Yes. And
But nobody got shot. I mean, I'm not taking it for the police, but let's look at it in its totality. Nobody got shot. It was terrible. And yeah, they should sue. Don't get it twisted. They made a mistake that traumatized my kid, right? Something needs to be done about that. Somebody needs to be made whole. But you wouldn't take their apology?
I wouldn't take their apology at all. I would tell them, keep their apology. And when somebody do it to their young daughter or their wife or their grandmama, then come back and let me know.
But haven't you made a mistake before, Al?
Not putting no pistol in nobody's face and telling them, if you put your hand in, think you're going to get your head blown up. Absolutely not.
Okay.
So I would tell them, keep their apology and tell them, take that apology when you go to church. And I still wouldn't forgive them and everything they get. May they soul rot in the hell.
All right. Thank you much, Al. Appreciate it. 833-212-1017 is the number.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Dr. Ken Harris, and the time is now, Milwaukee. You know, perspective is essential. What I found is the news behind the news is more important. I want you to leave my show with a sense of knowing what was missing that adds depth to the conversation. Tune in Monday through Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. on the new 101.7 The Truth app, or 101.7thetruth.com.
From my family and myself, I would like to say thank you to Gruber Law Offices for taking such good care of us.
I would say thank you because you're so human and so much of a friend during the whole process.
I'm super grateful for them representing me and doing all that they did for me.
I would just say thank you for making me feel better.
That's why I'm here, to say thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Good Karma Brands is celebrating Thriving Through. We are proud to share an encouraging story from the Truth's general manager, Cherie Harris, of thriving through her breast cancer diagnosis.
What words of encouragement or advice would you give to someone else who either might be in your shoes now, or they might be going through the first initial step of finding out and their brain might be a little frantic with just a bunch of information and scenarios? So what advice would you give them, or words of encouragement?
I would say, don't lose hope. This is not a death sentence. This is a reset sentence. This is something that's, yes, going to change you. It's going to change your perspective on a lot of things that you are going through. It's going to change your body makeup, but it does not define you. And it's something, like I always say, you can thrive through. And surround yourself with positive people. Surround yourself with a great medical team who advocates for you and give you the best care, because you're worth it. And just don't settle for something you don't know about. Ask questions. Hope is key. I would say having a positive mind and just being positive about life is key with this disease we call cancer.
How are you able to find the right team to go through this journey with you when it comes to the medical professionals that you have?
I did my research. I went online and I looked up the biographies of my team. I wanted someone who's innovative. I wanted to be part of a research program because I feel like my outcome is going to help the next woman or next male that encounters this disease. And so I would say, do your research, ask questions, ask about their history. You are entitled to do that. That's what you're paying them for. And find out, you know, what other specialties they have outside of cancer. You could be affected by the treatment, and you're going to need them to understand what that is for you.
Support our Thrive Through initiative by buying an exclusive Truth Thrive Through shirt by visiting 1017thetruth.com. All proceeds go to support breast cancer research.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, 833-212-1017 is the number. So I'm looking to, it's 77 degrees, 5 o'clock sunny. Looks like the low is going to get around 66. Overnight, I think the low is going to be only around 70, so by 6 a.m., it'll be around 65, and then the high tomorrow's around 81 with a chance of thunderstorms. Oh, yay, more rain. All right, 833-212-1017 is the number. Julian, you are on the new 1017, The Truth.
Oh, good afternoon. Thank you for taking my call. You ask what I would do?
Yes.
I would be upset. And I would have my attorney call for a press conference in which that attorney would announce a lawsuit against the department for the trauma caused that we would gladly drop if the department was willing to provide detailed information of how many instances these sorts of things have happened with people, unarmed people of color, having guns drawn on them, and that was reported or turned out to be a mistake. So detailed information about how many times it have these types of mistakes, quote unquote, happen to people who look like me. They can provide that. I gladly drop the lawsuit.
Thank you for that, Julian, but I do have a question. Would you look into it for everybody and not just people of color?
Okay. I would ask for everyone. Okay. But I would be very interested, frankly, I'd be very interested to know whether or not these sorts of mistakes happen with people who look like me mostly or not. That's basically what I would be trying to find out. We'll see how transparent the department would be and how interested they would be in providing that information.
Well, how would we know that those occurred based on complaints? That's a simple open records request that you could get from a department.
Well, actually, departments are not uniformly required to provide all sorts of details of those types of instances, particularly the demographic information about the people they stopped, use of deadly force. You would think, and we all probably assume, that departments are required to provide, keep records of and demographic information of those sorts of things, deadly force use, excessive force use, guns drawn. Actually, departments are not uniformly required to provide that information, which they should be, I'm convinced.
Most departments I know of, especially in the state of Wisconsin, would give you that information because it's required. So,
okay.
And as far as I know, many of the states and most of the time the federal government requires it. But you can again make an open records request for detailed information. And if they have it and there's no reason for them not to release it, which I can't see them not releasing it, they would have to release it.
I'm sorry. I've actually done research on the use of deadly force against unarmed African Americans, and I've sought that information, and that's where I found out that departments are not required by law.
Some departments,
police departments, there are law enforcement agencies across America are not uniformly. Some are not uniformly required to keep that sort of demographic information as far as who they pull over, who they shoot, unarmed people they shoot. They are not uniformly required to provide that information. And I would like to see that sort of information. And I think they should be uniformly required to provide that information. And I would like to know how many times or how often mistakes, quote unquote, like that happen with people who look like me as compared to other folks. I guess that's mainly what I'm getting at.
Well, the reason why I say that is because in my experience over, I guess about 30 years of law enforcement, people that were quote unquote bad did it to everybody. Many times it's what's the word I'm looking for? It's behavioral and it's habitual with bad cops. So the ones that would steal or the ones that would shoot would usually shoot anybody. Unfortunately.
Okay.
I think what happens is the numbers, when you isolate it out, many people will get upset when it's said they've shot more white people than they have black people. They shouldn't shoot anybody, but unfortunately, that has happened too many times. And part of the issue is when use of force, because law enforcement is a state issue, not a federal issue, each state has their own guidelines. I think one of the good things, and it can be bad, to have the federal government take over local law enforcement by setting the standards, because then different states have different issues and different problems. And if you try to make Minnesota and Wisconsin do what they do in Florida or take the same training, but we don't train for hurricanes and floods and alligators and stuff. You know what I mean? And so that's the case. But shooting wise, it needs to become uniform. Different places train different ways, but they'll hit me on social media. There are several ways you can get a hold of that information. We'll definitely talk.
And also, also those numbers you cited as far as deadly force against white Americans, those are aggregate numbers. And so, I mean, we're only African Americans, only 13% of the population. So, of course, numbers of white Americans shot will be larger than African Americans. But on a per person or percentage basis, stops involving African Americans compared to stops involving whites, I would argue that those numbers result in the deadly force used at a greater percentage.
I would love to see the data.
Okay. Fair enough.
All right. Great Thank conversation. You, Thank you, Julian.
Thanks.
Take care.
Appreciate it.
833-212-1017 is the number. Talk and text when we come back. Traffic, sports, and weather up next.
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance, because you'll feel protected no matter how the wind blows. Also, you can keep enjoying the home of your dreams. And our expert agents can help you save up to 23% when you bundle home with auto. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
I've got some cheese curds that I'm willing to share. Then I want to ride that giant slide over there. So if you've got 11 days to spare, won't you come with me to the Wisconsin State Fair? Won't you come with me to the Wisconsin? The great state of Wisconsin State Fair.
There's something for everyone at the Wisconsin State Fair, presented by U.S. Cellular, August 3rd through the 13th.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. What about those round trips that you plan in advance, which are perfect on your way there and perfect on your way back? Or those meetings with friends for which you make a group chat 3 months before so that nobody or anything is missing? Or your daughter's first birthday party? You planned it with such dedication that instead of the first, it felt like our quinces. The same way you plan each detail for those moments. Start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Protecting your family is the best plan you can make. Get started at ready.gov/plan.
Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
This is the story of a very special woman. In a matter of seconds, she turned herself into a great mathematician or an entrepreneur. Her knowledge was limitless and still is. She could also make monsters disappear, especially those that lurked in the shadows under the bed. Once, this woman put back together a teenage girl's broken heart, which had been shattered in 1,000 pieces. Just by giving her a bear hug. She masqueraded as a regular person at work, but as a superhero at home. Everyone knows her as Gabriella. I still call her Mom.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need to help, complete with tips and resources, at aarp.org/caregiving. A public service announcement brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Southbound 41, going to be riding the brakes quite a bit from about Silver Spring all the way down almost to Burleigh, then back on the brakes right around the North Avenue curve. Northbound side slowing down from Blue Mound Road all the way up to Swan Boulevard. Southbound 43, you are looking at a 20-minute ride from Brown Deer Road to downtown. That's slowing down from Silver Spring pretty much all the way down past Locust, with the northbound side hitting the brakes from before Fond du Lac Avenue all the way up past Keefe. East and westbound on 94, just watch out for some delays. The westbound side slow from 25th Street to Mitchell Boulevard. The eastbound side 84th through the stadium. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, mainly clear and comfortable. A low of 63 at the lakefront, 58 inland. Tomorrow, hazy sunshine with a high of 83. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 1017 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 1017 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Brandon Snide. It was a weekend Brewers fans will soon want to forget, as the Atlanta Braves busted out the brooms to complete the series sweep of Milwaukee with the 8-6 win over the Brewers on Sunday afternoon. With the loss, the Brewers now trailing the Cincinnati Reds in the NL Central Division by half a game. The Brewers will look to rebound in Washington tonight with Corbin Burns slated to get the start. That first pitch is set for 6:05. Over to the NFL, as the Green Bay Packers wrapped up week 1 of training camp on Sunday. Beginning today, the pads coming on in title. title town as head coach Matt LaFleur ensures the standard remains high for his football team in Green Bay.
The expectations are this, that guys go out there and compete to the best of their ability each and every day, that they come here with a great attitude and great energy.
Day 5 of training camp will get underway later today. This sports update is brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown teams. Member FDIC.
The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. Bob, you are on the new 1017 The Truth. How are you?
Hello, Doctor.
What's up,
Ken?
What's up?
I respect the opinions of those before me, but understanding I'm not the suing type, and I would explain to my kid in the back seat, or whatever kid it was, is traumatized. I explain that it's good we have officers, especially since they apologized, that will stop a very important stop, warranted that they might die. And, you know, so try to understand they really honestly made a mistake, and you know, and they came up to their mistake, and they tried to explain. And that I would try to unwind his traumatization in that way. And I'm not the suing type, and that's probably respecting the ones before me, though. You know, they whatever they want to do. This is my take on it, Doctor.
All right.
That's about it. Good to hear you, Doc.
All right. Take care.
Glad you're back.
Thank you.
All right.
All right. 833-212-1017 is the number. There's a statistic in here on white people, on just people shot from 2017 to 2023 by race. And it shows, of course, by far, which I don't know if that's an argument that there are more white people, so more white people would get shot. Anyway, because then are we asking that that killing be proportionate? Hey, excuse me. The percentage wise, we don't have enough Hispanic people shot. Let's shoot so we can even it out, or you know. And I know that's a silly way to think about it, but think about what we're asking. Statista.com shows, and who let me figure out who sent this to me, Mr. Madi, shows. In 2022, there were 389 white people, 225 black people, Hispanic 120, other 22, and unknown 341 people shot to death by the police. That's by race. In 2022, there were 1,097 fatal police shootings. Additionally, the rate of fatal police shootings among black Americans was much higher than that of any other ethnicity, standing at 5.8 fatal shootings per million of the population. However, there are how many hundred million white people and only like 41 or 42 million black people? Not only, but how about we get rid of all the shootings? I think we should work toward that. If we're going to compare it, let's compare it city by city in terms of how they do their policing and how they police black communities versus or brown communities or Asian communities versus others. There needs to be a lot more digging into the statistics. So when we generalize and just compare the surface, it looks like the person who's doing the comparing can make it whatever they want to make it. When in fact, I think it's important that it be shown race by race and the instances of how people are killed, not just that they were killed. Because we tend to look at it as every single person that was killed by the police was innocent of something, and they may not have been. And so I think if we do a granular dive, we're going to start to see that some were accidental. Like the woman that got killed in Greenfield, she got killed by the police. That's going to count. It was an accident. Circumstances matter. And we need to really, really look at circumstances and see what that carries. I'm not mitigating police killing people. I think it should go down to as close to zero as possible. I think what we have to look at is what are the instances that occurred that caused it to occur, and let's fix those too. Since everybody always accuses me, you're just taking up for the police. Caller said, black people can never catch up with colonists who murdered 7 million Native Americans. I got a great argument for that. I'm just not going to use it today. LT said, any information about guns drawn on people of color would have to be more detailed in circumstances. If the unarmed person was resisting arrest, high-speed chase. Yeah, exactly what I was saying. There are a lot of things that cause the discharge of a firearm, and every single one with a black person or white or Hispanic or Asian, whoever it is, man, woman, can't all be the police doing something wrong. At some point, we have to step up as a society and start telling people, stop doing that. Like literally, stop acting a fool. Stop doing things that are going to cause the police to show up and do stuff. Now, when you get the Frisco, Texas piece, well, cops made a mistake. You traumatized my kid, and I should be made whole for that. Everybody else gets made whole around the country. Everybody else made whole, as in W-H-O-L-E, as in paid. But for some reason, we always figure out a way that now is the time we should be nice. Well, can't always be nice. Julie said, I appreciate Al's level of drama. I would forgive, and I don't know what I would, I don't know, and I don't know that I would sue. I would definitely want a public apology and for the officers to maybe go through extra training. They may not need extra training. I mean, think about what the person did. They were supposed to type A-Z, and they typed A-K. That qualifies for me as what I affectionately call it's a brain fart, right? Boop. The problem is it escalated, and what should have happened is somebody should have double-checked it, confirmed the plate. Can you confirm the plate, so-and-so, so-and-so? For instance, before we go to break, that's one of the issues we have when we removed the dispatcher from wanted checks. So what happens is now is that we have these MDTs, right? We have these mobile data terminals, you know? We got a computer in the car, so you run it. Now I'm multitasking, doing multiple things in multiple places and multiple times and going on, and the odds of me making a mistake go up significantly. Now I typed in the wrong number, and it comes back as stolen. If I were listening and the dispatcher said, hey, squad, you know, what, my squad number was 6201. 6201, I have your Arizona plate, and I would have immediately been looking at a Arkansas plate and went, stand by. I already knew I screwed up. That other person in there reading it back to me would have been able to notify me that I ran Arizona instead of Arkansas. Now, the other thing is the officer should have read and looked at the to make sure and guaranteed that the information that they ran was correct for the plate. And I've done that before. I've misread a sticker on a car that was actually registered when it wasn't because it changed and the color changed. Like little small things can happen. And had it come back stolen, you rerun it. Like it would have literally been, let me confirm that. You know, there are multiple ways to do that. And so I don't know what their procedures are or protocols, but, and I'd love to see how long that officer's been on the job. I would say, no, I'm not going to take a guess because then I might be wrong. God forbid I'm actually wrong.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
This is 1017 The Truth's Tori Lowe, and I am Milwaukee. The Tori Lowe Show has become a resource for the community. I enjoy having open, on-air discussions about what we can do to regroup, rethink the black man, the black woman, and the black child. This show is about that action, and I want all the smoke. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
Bikers need protection, not just from other drivers, but unfortunately from insurance companies too. If you've been injured in a motorcycle crash, call Gruber Law Offices today. Bikers are often blamed for causing the accident because the insurance companies simply don't want to pay. At Gruber Law Offices, we've been fighting for injured bikers and their families for more than 30 years. Trust us to fight for what you deserve. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
At UW Credit Union, our home loans have everything you need for your next big step, including up to $750 off closing costs for all home buyers. And first-time buyers can save even more. So if you're ready to trade roomies for more room or your town home for an out-of-town home, UW Credit Union will be with you from start to furnished. UW Credit Union. Apply online today. Equal housing lender. Credit may be limited as required by program. Visit uwcu.org for details.
The golden days of summer are here. More Brewers games, sun-drenched days of tailgating, and exhilarating summer nights are waiting for you at American Family Field. Embrace it all with your crew while Brewers baseball season reaches its peak, because the best days of the year won't be here forever. Make the most of it and plan your game day at Brewers.com today.
Don't you wish your life came with a warning app?
Stop. That dog does not want to be petted.
Just a little heads up before something bad happens.
Move your coffee cup away from your computer.
Oh, no.
So you can have more control.
Stop. You're texting your boss by mistake.
Uh-oh. Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. With early diagnosis and a few healthy changes like managing your weight, getting active, stopping smoking, and eating healthier, you can stop prediabetes before it leads to type 2 diabetes. It's easy to learn your risk. Take the 1-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org.
Warning, the cap is loose on that ketchup.
Ugh. Don't wait. You have the power to change the outcome. Visit doihaveprediabetes.org today. That's doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its Prediabetes Awareness Partners.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, 833-212-1017 is the number. LT said, when black people drive through white communities and are profiled and pulled over, it is to protect the members of the white community. When white people are profiled and pulled over in black communities, it's for the protection of those white people. Would you agree with that statement? No. The second part, when white people are pulled over and profiled in black communities, there's the assumption that they're there to buy drugs or do something nefarious or pick up a hooker, which I say is completely disrespectful to a black community, but that you assume that the only time a white person comes there is when they're there to do something wrong, as if that's the only place you can do something wrong. No, because I've been in many white communities. Matter of fact, wasn't there a homicide in Glendale the other day? Anyway, yeah, we have a lot of crime in communities, and there's enough for them. However, the first part, yeah, profiling people. I'll tell you a story I had flying back from Dallas. I flew back first class. Guy gets on the airplane, not sitting in first class, mind you. Looks and is startled, like, you know how people look at you like, what are you doing here? And you know, I get it every now and then. Some people look at you like, what are you doing over here? You don't belong here. You can't afford to be here. What? And I just thought, wow, 2023. But then I remember I was in the state of Texas. So, you know, go figure. Mr. Medee said, facts, brother. 99% justifiable cop killings. I can tell you, Mr. Medee, that's not true. That's not true. Not at all. Some of those are not. One too many. One unjustified police officer shooting of a black man or anybody is not acceptable. But especially with black people. And there is a pattern of going after black people and going after black people in a way or for a reason that is what I like to call nebulous. Like, do you go after other people about that? If there's one thing I did traffic-wise, I had my pet peeves about traffic because I knew what it could cause, and I wrote a lot of tickets for the same stuff. And you have to check yourself. Are you going to show discretion? Are you going to do this? Are you going to do that? What were the, and then be consistent. But if you consistently write tickets to the same kind of people, that's one thing. If you consistently write tickets and add tickets because this person, you know, they're little subtleties. We'll talk about it one day. 414-507 says maybe we should count up the bullets per body it takes to bring a black person down as opposed to a white person. Maybe that would be a better statistic for some people. The caller said, colonists did come up with the Second Amendment, which allows people who should not have guns to buy them just because they were born in America. What do you mean should not have guns? If you were born in America, you can legally own it. You can have one. I don't understand. Multitasking is a part of the day for most working people, brain surgeons, mail carriers, and law enforcement. Not true. Not true. The human beings suck at multitasking. They're terrible at multitasking. Like, OMG, terrible at multitasking. I'm just saying. Multitasking will get you in trouble because your brain is not wired to multitask. We like to think we can, we like to think we do, and then it doesn't turn out right, and we wonder why, because you're doing too much stuff. Brain surgeons don't multitask. Mail carriers certainly don't multitask. If you think walking, the root thing of walking is multitasking, I don't know. Law enforcement, multitask? That's what gets them in trouble. And then they end up in jail like they belong because they did something wrong. I'm just saying. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Tory Lowe's show is coming up next. I'll see you in about 22 hours. We can hang out and talk about what's going on in the news of the day, do the top five at five and do all that. Thank you, Rhea. Appreciate you. Welcome back. Oh, wait a minute. I was the one gone. Okay, my bad. And we'll be back. Take care. God bless. And I'm out.